Hi, Firas here.
Hi, this is Clemens, and right now we want to talk about the accusation that people often bring up against personality typology, and that is that it boxes people, it places people in specific boxes. Now, I came across this accusation very often because it's something I naturally do and introduce people to, and also I use it in, I give seminars about personality typology, so I'm very familiar with this objection. And in order for you to get the objection, we are going to do a little role play. So so I just imagine I just got very enthusiastic, fired up, and just illustrated, like, look, this is a system for you to understand people, and it's actually, you don't have to understand everybody individually, but you can kind of understand their core very quickly, and that way you can improve the relationship so much faster and really connect with them on a deeper level. And this is an amazing system of knowledge.
No. Okay, you cannot box me, right? You cannot tell me that 7 billion people on the planet can be categorized into only 16 personalities, right? You are a liar.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Right. So, exactly. So, the answer to this is...
No. Not only a liar, you are completely politically incorrect, okay? You are anti-humane. That's what you are. You are not a human being.
at this point, of course, I would have to cancel the seminar because there's no way to get out of this. So what I think, if we step out of this room right now, because I'm getting quite scared here, is that
I am unique, okay? I am an individual. Keep that in mind.
Yes, exactly. So what actually is the case, that the MBTI is not opposing uniqueness in any way, right? That it is not a threat to individuality. It actually, I see it more as enhancing individuality.
Yeah. For example, we have different individualities, but we're both ENFPs.
Exactly.
Like, it's not.
So it is something that doesn't define us in a limiting way.
Yes.
It is more understanding the way we think, we operate, and this opens up a lot of possibilities for personal development. Actually,
I think one way of looking at it, I don't know if you agree with me or not, it's like the personality type is the building,
mm-hmm.
and then so that's, you know, same building and me, but then what's in the building is more the individual uniqueness.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. That would be one way of putting it. I think also it's, you know, like it's like other traits, right? Like like you're a man, or you're Lebanese, I'm German, right? It's something, you know, like I might be an untypical German, but I'm still a German, and you might be untypical Lebanese.
You're more anal than I am.
Exactly. So to conclude with this whole thing, actually, it is not something that limits individuality, but it enhances individuality. Because once you kind of accept the fact that you are a personality type, you can actually understand yourself so much better. And with that knowledge that you're embracing, use that for personal development.
Yes.
Okay. Right. Thank you.
Thank you.